No Unity. Farewell. So, Unity destroyed the trust of tons of game developers, including myself, by rolling out this runtime feed thingy. Good news is, some changes have been reversed, and John Riccitiello, former CEO of the infamous EA and current CEO of Unity, has stepped down. However, the breach of trust has already been broken and cannot be repaired. So, that leaves me with two possible routes, AAA Unreal Engine or open source Godot engine. Well, AAA is not my thing, so Godot it is. Shall I introduce you to Grumsource, please? The Godot game engine. I'll begin by creating a new project in Godot. What do I do now? Tutorials.
Welcome to this engaging crash course on creating your own platformer game with Godot 4.0.
2 hours later.
Alright, I think I have a pretty solid understanding of the interface and system of Godot. So it's time for the ultimate idea. I recently participated in the Pasta Game Challenge hosted by Blackthorn Prod and created a crappy platformer rage game where you move by the recoil of the gun. And that is exactly the ultimate idea. So, my goal? Learn Godot in 24 hours and remake my game. Alright, I started by adding a floor, then I drew a player, threw it into a scene, and attached a script to the player to move by the recoil, and... yeah, so after some researching, I fixed the bug. And then I tinkered a bit with Godot's particle system to create an explosion effect and instantiated it whenever the player shoots. I later drew a platform and added it into the game so that I can finally get rid of those white placeholder platforms. I also made some moving platforms to make the game harder, since it's supposed to be a rage game. Well, I turned the player red and added it as enemies. Again, it's a rage game. Next, I made the platform generator that spawns in random platforms so that each play would be different, which kinda didn't work only for me to spend an eternity to remember that Godot's y-axis position is negative as it goes up, which is a little weird. Afterwards, I implemented a score counter that basically counts how high you are so that you can watch it drop from 5000 to 0 and wreck your computer. Anyways, I finally got rid of the ugly green blocks of boundaries and made them look better. I next implemented the function for actually being able to win the game, but I doubt you guys will be able to complete this. Then, I packed together a start menu because every game has that. Next up, I created a quit button so that you don't have to bear this torture and just quit. And then a timer to remind you how much time you wasted raging in this game. After that, I added some juice, or in other words, camera shake, and... whoops.
1 eternity later.
Alright, I fixed it. Next, I added sound effects and some polish to the game. And just like that, after hours of torture, we're done. The game is finished. My personal best, by the way, was 1 minute and 4 seconds. Try to beat it. Or you can't do that. Okay, so, I've learned Godot. The engine is pretty good, and I think I'll continue to use it and finally quit Unity. Anyways, in case you wanted to check out the game for yourself, a link is down below in the description or the comment section. By the way, if you wanted to practice touch typing to make games faster, watch this video by clicking here. I'm out, and until next time.